Hi, this is Sandra Henry Stocker, author of the Unix as a Second Language blog on Network World. In today's Linux tip, we're going to look at the find command, a tool that will prove very useful when you're trying to locate a file or a set of files based on almost any criteria. Maybe the file's size, name, owner, permissions, when it was last accessed or updated, when its status last changed, whether it's executable or empty, its inode number, and more. In fact, the number of options available for the find command is enough to make you dizzy. So let's take a look at how it works. Given only a file name, find is going to look in the current directory only. So with this command, we're looking in the current directory for a file named try-me, and it found one. Now, if we add some criteria to the search, we're going to find that the command looks in the current directory as well as subdirectories, which is the way it's usually used. So we do that, we can see we now find two copies of this try-me file. We can also search for files by size, we say size and specify the size we're looking for here, and we can see we find a number of them. We're using sudo here because my user account is not going to allow me to look in other users' home directories. And notice that I can start my search in the home directory regardless of where I happen to be sitting in the file system right now. And in this find command, I'm looking for files that are larger than 10,000 bytes. Now, if I run the same command with dash ls in the end, I also get to see the inode numbers, file sizes in blocks and bytes, and file permissions along with the file's full locations. So I'm just going to add ls to the end, and you can see how much more information is available for me to look at. Now let's try some commands that are a bit more exotic. With this next command, I'm going to be looking for files with particular permissions. The owner and group must both have write permission. Other permissions in this case are going to be irrelevant. So I'll do my sudo find home nemo, specify I want to look at permissions, user has write permission, group has write permission. And I find quite a few files that have both the user and group having write permission. Now with this next command, I'm going to be looking for files that are empty. So I say find, starting in the current directory, files that are empty. And I only want files, not directories, so I put F and then ls, so it will show me the details when I find the files. And you can see there are a lot of empty directories right now. So now, let's count how many files have been accessed in the last hour in home. So again, I'll use the sudo command so I can look throughout the home directory. Amin-60, that's the 60 minutes. And then I'm just going to pipe the output of that to WC so I can just count how many files. I don't need to see them all. And it's telling me that four files have been accessed in the last directory. In the next command, I'm going to find files in and below the current directory that don't belong to me. So find starting here. The exclamation point means not, where the owner of the file is me. And provide the details. So it found two files that don't belong to me. Now I could do the same thing if I wanted to make this generic to work for anybody. Again, I could just put the user in there and then that command would show anybody that kind of information but in their own directory. In the next command, I'm going to find files that don't belong to me and have it find ask me if I want to remove them. So find starting in home, which is of course my home directory, not where the owner is not me, and then prompt me to remove them. These brackets represent the name of the files that are found, and then I have to end the command with those two characters. Now it's prompting me to tell it whether or not these files should be removed, but I'm going to choose not to remove them. And you'll see why in a minute. Okay. We can also find files that have no currently active user. Find using the starting with the current directory. Oops. No user. I'm gonna type it and show me the details. So one of the two files that's in my directory that doesn't belong to me doesn't belong to any user with an active account on the system, and you can tell that both because the find command found it and because the username is shown just with a number. We can also add an exec clause to move these files to a different directory. So let's change this to move the files to temp, and we'll go like that. Now if I look at temp shs, I see the file is sitting there. So notice how we had to end the exec clause with those two characters, the backslash and the semicolon. You can use an exec clause to run almost any command involving the file, whether it's move, remove, change owner, head and tail commands. Those are all very useful. As I said up front, there are a lot of options for finding specific files using the find command and manipulating them in some way. Well, that's your Linux tip for today. If you like this video, please hit the like and share buttons. For more Linux tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and networkworld.com. Cool.